What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, it looks like undefeated, unified WBC, IBF, welterweight world champion, superstar boxer, Earl the Truth Spence Jr., 27 wins, no losses, no draws, 21 big wins by way of knockout. Earl Spence Jr., 31 years of age, stands at 5'9.5" with a 72-inch arm reach. With that said, Errol Spence was set to make his ring return August 21st against legendary 8-division world champion, iconic Filipino superstar boxer, Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao, August 21st, Las Vegas, Nevada, T-Mobile Arena. But Errol Spence, he suffered a detached broken retina, eye injury, and he had to be pulled from the fight. With that said, it looks like Errol Spence is set to make his ring return in February of 2022. All eyes and all signs initially pointed to Errol Spence in a unification bout against Cuban star boxer, who's the WBA super champion, who replaced Errol Spence in the Manny Pacquiao fight. And he defeated Manny Pacquiao via unanimous decision, that being Yordanis Ugas. But the WBA, World Boxing Association, President Gilberto Mendoza, they had other plans, and they decided to force Yordanis Ugas to fight Stanionis in a WBA mandatory showdown, okay? So now Yordanis Ugas has to fight upcoming welterweight star boxer Stanionis in his next fight instead of a unification bout. Yordanis Ugas wasn't happy. And Errol Spence and Yordanis Ugas, according to Yordanis Ugas, they already had a contract signed to face off February 26th of 2022. With that said, now Errol Spence, who has a mandatory IBF challenger, he looks like that's going to be the replacement. Now, a lot of people, they're saying, they wonder if former unified welterweight world champion superstar boxer Keith One Time Thurman will be the replacement for Yordanis Ugas. Keith Thurman has been inactive. Keith Thurman, the last time we saw him in the ring, he lost to Manny Pacquiao for that same very own WBA title. That was July of 2019. Okay, Keith Thurman is a superstar in the sport of boxing. He beat the likes of Sean Porter, Danny Garcia, been in big fights, lost a close decision to Manny Pacquiao. So Keith Thurman would be the logic replacement. The problem is, Errol Spence doesn't take too kind to Keith Thurman. Errol Spence was looking for a showdown with Keith Thurman for quite some time, and Keith Thurman never granted it. And because Keith Thurman never granted it, Errol Spence, he's on record as saying he'll never fight Keith Thurman. He'll never give him the opportunity. And now that Keith Thurman, in February 2020, Keith Thurman would have been out the ring for 3 years, okay? Inactivity and being irrelevant, okay? He's out of the spotlight, and he doesn't have a world title. So I'm hard-pressed to see Errol Spence fight Keith Thurman. But his mandatory in Abdulkarov, right, 18 wins, no losses, no draws, 10 wins by way of knockout, 28 years of age, 5'9.5", with a 71-inch arm reach, okay? He's from Uzbekistan, and he's undefeated. He's the IBF number one mandatory challenger. So he's last fought March of this year against Javier Flores. He got a stoppage victory. So it's possible to see Errol Spence have to honor his IBF mandatory before they force it. Okay, so it just makes sense since Yordanis Ugas has to fight Stanionis. It just makes sense for Errol Spence to go ahead and get his mandatory out the way before that stands in the way in the future of a unification bout. So Errol Spence looks like he's going to be making his ring return in February, and it looks like it's going to be Abdulkarov, okay, who is his IBF mandatory challenger. Now, I know a lot of people, including Errol Spence, he wants to do the biggest fights possible. Errol Spence, his last three fights have been on pay-per-view against 4-division world champion, Mexican superstar boxer Mikey Garcia. Then he fought in a unification bout against 2-time welterweight world champion superstar boxer Showtime Sean Porter, and then his last fight against 2-division world champion Puerto Rican superstar boxer Danny Swift Garcia. So his last three fights have been on pay-per-view, okay? And so with that said, you know, you can see that Errol Spence wants the biggest fights possible. I don't see this Abdukhov fight being on pay-per-view for Errol Spence because nobody knows who Abdukhov is. Now, again, he's from Uzbekistan, so he does have that following behind him, but it's not a big enough following for it to be a pay-per-view showdown. Yordanis Ugas versus Errol Spence is a pay-per-view showdown because it's a unification bout for one, and Yordanis Ugas, the momentum, Yordanis Ugas just beat Manny Pacquiao in replacement of Errol Spence. So that makes that a pay-per-view fight, and three belts will be on the line, so it's understandable for that one to be on pay-per-view. But Errol Spence versus Abdukhov is not a pay-per-view worthy fight. So I'm hard-pressed to see that be on pay-per-view. But Keith Thurman, on the other hand, and Errol Spence, well, that would be pay-per-view, a pay-per-view worthy fight to see Keith Thurman and Errol Spence fight. That would be pay-per-view worthy. The problem is Errol Spence has no interest in fighting Keith Thurman. And on the flip side of that, Keith Thurman brings nothing to the table. He would have been inactive for, you know, the better part, nearly 3 years. He doesn't have a belt. So Errol Spence, you know, it's a hard sell for Errol Spence to take the Keith Thurman fight, because when Keith Thurman was in position to fight Errol Spence, when he was a champion and he was relevant and he was viewed as the best welterweight in the world, he didn't want to give Errol Spence an opportunity. Even after Errol Spence defeated Kell Brook and became IBF champion in the UK on a big stage, Keith Thurman still was not willing to oblige and go into a unification bout with Errol Spence, okay? So Keith Thurman is now 32 years of age. Once again, Keith Thurman hasn't fought since July 2019. You know, Keith Thurman, 29 wins, 1 loss, no draws, 22 wins by way of knockout. Keith Thurman stands at 5'7.5" with a 69-inch arm reach, okay? So it makes sense if Errol Spence wants to have a pay-per-view fight to face off against Keith Thurman. But like I said, you know, Keith Thurman is irrelevant. He's been out of sight, out of mind, okay? And he doesn't have a belt. And on top of that, Keith Thurman just recently did an interview in which Keith Thurman, he stated that he's not truly interested in coming right away, straight away into a big fight, because Keith Thurman, he wants to have a tune-up fight, okay, before he goes into the big fights. He wants to make sure that he gets off, knocks off the ring rust before he jumps up and jumps in the ring with a big-name challenger in a big fight like Errol Spence Jr. But I'm sure Keith Thurman would be hard-pressed to turn down the opportunity, because he's on record trying to go Errol Spence into taking the fight. He just recently stated that, you know, Errol Spence is salty and he needs to put his feelings aside and make the biggest fights possible. And I'm sure Errol Spence is going to look at it and say, well, when I was trying to do the same thing, you wasn't willing to do it. Now you're in a position where you have nothing to lose, and now you're in a position where you need to get back in relevancy, and now you're in a position where you want the biggest fights possible. Now you want to take the fight. So I'm sure maybe PBC, Premier Boxing Champions, founder and advisor Al Haymon could, you know, talk Errol Spence into accepting the Keith Thurman fight, you know, but hard pressed to see that. And it would just make sense, yeah, going to a big pay-per-view showdown. But Errol Spence himself is coming back off of an injury, you know, and Keith Thurman is coming off of, injuries and surgeries and long layoffs himself and a hiatus himself. So, and Errol Spence need to go ahead and satisfy this mandatory before the IBF, International Boxing Federation, forced the fight on Errol Spence. So, we got to see how that unfolds. But I think this is going to be, you know, this guy, you know, this Uzbekistan, I think he's going to be a tough fight for Errol Spence, you know, but it's a good, solid fight for Errol Spence to get back in the ring and get some ring rust off. And because, again, Errol Spence hasn't fought since his fight with Danny Garcia. That was December of 2020, okay? We're heading in December of this year. So if Errol Spence doesn't fight That means Errol Spence would have been out the ring a year again himself. Now, don't forget, he had the 14-month layoff, you know, after he suffered that horrific car accident just 12 days after unifying the belts against Sean Porter, okay? He unified the belts against Sean Porter September 28th of 2019, and he suffered that horrific car accident October 10th of 2019, right? Just 12 days later. So, with that said, he would have been out the ring. His fight with Danny Garcia was in December of 2020. So he would have been out the ring for over a year himself, you know. So he got to get some ring rust off, you know, and get some activity under his belt as well. And I like this fight with his IBF mandatory. So let's see how everything unfolds and plays out. Keith Thurman, Errol Spence still would be a big fight. I would favor Errol Spence to win the fight. Bigger, stronger, younger, you know, Keith Thurman, longer hiatus than Errol Spence. Errol Spence is southpaw. Errol Spence is great at going to the body. That's where Keith Thurman seems to show his most vulnerabilities. I would favor Errol Spence to win the fight. We saw Manny Pacquiao get the Keith Thurman body with left hooks and almost stop Keith Thurman in the 10th round of their fight. And Keith Thurman spit out his mouthpiece and circled the ring to avoid being stopped by Manny Pacquiao. And Manny Pacquiao is not the body puncher Errol Spence is. So I would favor Errol Spence. But I think a tougher competitive fight that we don't know of is his IBF mandatory challenger in Aguadavov. So let's see how this unfolds. But it looks like Errol Spence will be back in February. And looks like it's going to be his IBF mandatory challenger, not Keith Thurman. But that's all I got for y'all. Make sure you hit the like button. Drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. Hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.
You're watching Blue Blood Sports TV. Wow.